Hi guys! For project, I need a protection board for 2S lithium ion batteries. 2S means that two battery cells are electrically connected in series. Since lithium ion batteries are relatively sensitive to overcharging, undervoltage and excessive charging or load currents, and the batteries may not be charged in a balanced manner,
I will protect it.
The individual cells must be protected from this. That's why I had a look around on Aliexpress and found this offer here. The board is suitable for 2S lithium ion battery packs. The dimensions are small enough for applications with little space. The reviews are also good. Here's the description. The voltage monitoring should be very precise. This is important because the limits are very tight. The overcurrent monitoring takes place in three stages. This makes sense because the protection circuit should not be activated incorrectly with a very short inrush current. The normal permissible load current is 3 amps, which suits my application. The quiescent current is only 3 microamps. This is important so the connected battery pack is not discharged by the protective board within a short time. At 3 microamps, an average of only around 2.2 milliampere hours is consumed within a month. If the quiescent current were 300 microamps, it would already be 220 milliampere hours. So 3 microamps is really a good value. This is how the module is wired. The positive line of the load is then connected to P plus and the negative line of the load to P minus. Yes, great! Then I can order the modules. If the module is also interesting for you, you can find the link to it in the product description. But how does the module actually achieve these values? Let's take a look at which components were installed. Here are two ICs of the type 8205LA. I found the Chinese datasheet for this and had it translated into English. They are 20 watt N MOSFETs that get by with an astonishingly low control voltage. These MOSFETs switch the lines of the battery cells on and off. The control can then only be in the small IC next to it. The model number is FM7021CB. I actually had to search for quite a while, but I actually found the Chinese datasheet and had it translated into English. So it is a special lithium-ion protection IC for two cells connected in series. And as expected, the IC has a delay for the protection functions. The IC's quiescent current in energy-saving mode is really very little. Oh, and there are different variants with slightly different values. The top line contains our chip. And here's the typical application circuit. A very important property of the chip is that it resets itself again automatically after the protection functions have been activated. In my experience, commercial battery packs usually contain such ICs without a reset function. If you disconnect the batteries, for example, the protection IC blocks permanently and can therefore no longer be used. The modules have now arrived. This is what they look like. I will get them out of the package. The workmanship looks good. I don't see any bad solder joints or short circuits. Very pleasing. But now I can break off a module from the panel. Here you can see the connections in detail. Here I now have to solder cables to test the module. So the cables are connected. Of course, I won't test the module with real batteries. Instead, I'm using two electrolytic capacitors connected in series. The electrolytic capacitors are connected. If I now connect a voltage of 9 volts, the protection module should disconnect the battery if the voltage on one of the cells or across both cells becomes too high. Aha, the shutdown already occurs at a total voltage of 7.97 volts. The maximum permissible voltage is 8.4 volts. So one of the cells must have charged faster to a value above 4.2 volts. Let's see what voltages are on the individual cells. volts, it's definitely not the cell. 4.08 volts, that's the cell. That shows how important it is to only connect almost identical battery cells together. From the beginning again, I pre-charged the cells individually. The left measuring device shows the voltage of the left cell. The right measuring device shows the voltage of the right side. So that I can vary the rate of increase of the voltage, I placed a 100k potentiometer in the supply line. As a disadvantage, if the right cell reaches 4.2 volts first, I discharge the left cell a little with a 10k resistor. Now it's getting exciting. When will it be shut off? 3.268 volts is the switch-off voltage. That's a wonderful value. My battery cells can be charged up to 4.25 volts, so the switch-off value is well positioned. The switch-off should not happen accidentally too early in the event of an overcharge, but also not significantly too late. The limits are tight, and this protection module impresses me with its well-measured cutoff voltage just above the maximum voltage that occurs. I have seen completely different values for protection modules. Now I want to see the lower cutoff voltage. Everything is prepared again. The left measuring device shows the voltage of the left cell. I am now waiting until the voltage has dropped due to self-discharge until it is cut off. Aha! At 2.895 volts on this cell, the cutoff occurs. That matches very precisely the cutoff voltage of 2.9 volts specified in the datasheet. And my lithium ion cells can even tolerate undervoltage down to 2.65 volts. Very nice! We have now tested the basic functions. Now I know that the protection modules can be used and can continue with the larger project. I hope the video has been interesting for you so far. Stay tuned for the video about the larger project. Give me a thumbs up and please write a comment saying which country you live in. I'm happy about that, and the algorithm likes that too. If you're not already a valued subscriber, you now have the chance to become one. Take a look at my playlists, you'll find even more interesting videos from me there. By looking and clicking on my product recommendations, you will help my channel. If you liked this video, I would also be happy to receive a small donation via PayPal friends. See the end card for details. Stay tuned, I will see you next time. Bye bye.